Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I got Rat's cage bottom here prepped up, ready to go. I hit it with some rust paint from the hardware with the little black LVLP spray gun. So before we get started on that, I got something else to show you. Okay, buddy just dropped off some bike parts here to get repair and paint. He his bike in the ditch, smashed her up a little bit. This is a replacement fairing for the front. Somebody's already started knocking it down here, so it looks like it is the plastic primer, a silver metallic possibly, candy and clear. Now, I got that piece, and I've got the trunk, or the back box, I don't know what you call it, I'm not a bike rider, but this is the one he wants repainted, and this is the one that got smashed up. Now my problem is I contacted my local paint guy and they don't do motorcycle paint, so I'm gonna have to find something to match this kind of a brandy wine kind of color. Kind of off the shelf, so if anybody has any information on that, I would appreciate it. Leave a comment. Okay, so this little job's all prepped up. Just sanded it back with some 80. Just nothing special. It's just a quick little paint job. Like I said in the intro, plain old hardware store Elklide rust paint. Cut this I believe 2-to-1 with acetone. That's from a previous job. That is flat black. And I'm gonna shoot it with this little guy here. Give him another go. I was kind of happy with the truck box situation, and we'll see what happens. Okay, that's a nice first coat. Let that dry for maybe a half hour or so before I hit it again because of type of paint that it is. Now, remember the truck cap video? I fiddled with this gun nonstop. I'm actually running 20 psi, one open on the fan. It seems once you hit one open, that's it. The rest of the knob doesn't really do anything. And 1.5 turns open on the fluid. That laid down pretty nice. It's running about a 50% overlap. So come back in about a half hour and hit it again. Okay, so I put this outside to basically cook in the sun. That's two nice coats on there. It's already, I don't know if you can see on the camera, but it's already starting to dry out from the heat of the sun. Let this bake out here for a while. I think the little gun did a nice little job for this type of project. Okay, this side's all done, dried up, ready to go. I'm gonna flip this over Reload the gun. Something I need to mention is that when you're working with this kind of paint, if you gotta let your gun sit for a little bit between coats, you need to dump your gun out, put some thinners in there to keep things from gumming up. It's just the way this paint works. So I don't think I had enough flat black left, so I mixed up some gloss and added it to the flat black just to shoot the inside. So I'll set you up here and get going. Okay, nice quick coat there. I'm gonna put this out in the sun to dry up for a minute, and then bring it back in and put another coat on. Okay guys, Rat's cage bottom turned out not too badly. This little spray gun didn't do too bad of a job after all. I'm pretty happy with that little project. I'll catch you in the next one.